A good cheese board is always a win at a holiday gathering, but instead of focusing on things that go well with wine, why not local bourbon? It is a huge trend this year. Rachel's here and asking the very important questions. Why not bourbon?
Why not bourbon?
Well, I think it's great.
It'd be a fun twist on a holiday party or like a cocktail party get
together. You don't have to sell me.
I know.
I'm already sold.
But bourbon's very popular right now.
So
why not talk about how to pair food with it in a smart way?
And you don't think about that because normally you always think, oh, we got to pair wine with everything.
Yeah, right.
But
let's
this
go bourbon.
Let's go different.
Well, let's talk about what bourbon tastes like
first.
Let's do that. Because it's important to know what it tastes like to know what to pair with it.
Bobby's waiting.
Everyone's waiting in the wings. Bourbon is made with corn, so it's a little sweet. Mm-hmm. It's also made with rye, a little spicy, little barley for a little nuttiness, but it also maybe has some caramel, vanilla kind of undertones to it, dried fruit sweetness. So we're looking for things that taste the same as that.
Yes.
That's a foolproof strategy.
And by the way, we have some great distilleries here in Minnesota.
We do. We're going to talk about that. We brought two local bourbon makers products here today to pair with these lovely cheeses I brought. All local except for one. This first one I want to show you is washed with whiskey. This is North Fork Munster cheese.
Okay.
So it's washed with whiskey. That's obviously going to pair with it really well. Our signature cheddar, aged 4 years, nice sweetness, caramel flavor. So again, same things I'm using to describe the bourbon are being used to describe the cheese. Jeff Select Gouda, an award-winning Gouda, a little bit of nuttiness to it. A Comté, this is, again, the only non-local cheese here.
Okay.
This is from France. Got a nice nutty
flavor,
too.
That's a good place to go if you're not going to be local.
If you're not going to get
France
local cheese.
Yeah.
Or Wisconsin,
you're kind of going all the way there, for sure.
And then Shepherd's Way Farms makes two really great ones. I always love a blue on a cheese board. Their Big Woods Blue is a nice choice. It's got the sweetness that you're looking for in a blue, but it's also got saltiness, which plays nicely with it.
And it's strong, but it's good.
But it's really good.
Yeah.
And they make an extra aged goat, sheep's milk cheese called Frisiago that I really like as well, too.
Okay.
But then for accompaniments, look for things like this Chuck's Fred Salami from Red Table. Spicy. You know, we mentioned spicy. And then also chocolate. I love chocolate with bourbon. So I brought, this is a bar from Tawar Chocolate. They make this in Fergus Falls. They make a bunch of different bars, but this one's called Caramel Crack.
Oh, I like that.
And I thought the caramel flavor and the sweet would be really nice with bourbon.
And it's so much easier, too, because you just, I mean, bourbon and all, you don't have to, you're not going through 80 different kinds of flavors. With wine, it's a little tougher to find the combination.
It can be a little bit tougher.
Yeah.
So as far as those local bourbons I mentioned, I brought some from Jay Carver. I know you like this one here.
I do.
They make both a bourbon and a rye, straight rye. Those are 80 proof. They're aged traditionally in the charred oak barrels that are coopered here in Minnesota. 80 proof means 40% alcohol, which is really strong.
That'll
but
do
for
the job.
Bourbon, that's the minimum. So that's like for a good entry level bourbon. This one here, that we should pour this one, Laura.
Sure.
This one is from noted foodie, Heather Manley makes these from Crooked
today.
Water Spirits. And
by the way,
all
these
like
cherries
Heather.
Are awesome. I already tried one of these. They're delicious.
These are soaked
cherries?
In bourbon,
yes,
Jack Rudy
soaked.
Cocktail
they're
Company.
Really, try one, they're amazing.
Bourbon-soaked cocktail cherries. And
they're
this,
really
she makes a great bourbon, Kings Point Bourbon.
Thank you.
It's aged in old port casks from Portugal, so a little non-traditional. This is a 90
that's
proof.
That's quite a pour.
Nice
pour.
Right
so this is 90 proof?
It's also
don't pour me a lot.
Got the flavorings of an old-fashioned in it. So it's got the bitters, it's got the sweetener, it's got the flavorings that you're looking for. So this is a ready-to-pour cocktail, not
cheers.
Just a straight bourbon. So that's
to getting home.
Cheers to getting home. This is your happy holiday cocktail.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy holidays.
Can't be simpler than this to make.
No, really simple, really easy.
And,
very
for that being as strong as it is, it's not overwhelming. It's not
again,
overpowering.
It's not just the bourbon. It's got the flavorings in it that would make it a true old-fashioned cocktail. So this is a ready-to-pour cocktail. And so it's a great choice. And I love these spirits from Crooked Water because the bottles are just so beautiful.
They are really
cool. Really gorgeous.
And the ones from Jay Carver, we sell in a gift package in the wine shops. You can buy this together as a set. We call it our Minnesota Manhattan. So you can buy this already boxed up for you. Beautiful gift packaging.
And this one?
And it comes with a jar of the Jack Rudy cocktail cherries, too.
Mm-hmm.
So you 2-to-1 bourbon to vermouth to make a Manhattan. Just throw in the cocktail cherries, throw it over ice, and it's ready to go.
I'm doing my pairing. It's delicious. This all works well together.
Yeah.
It's very good.
I want some of that caramel
will you
crack.
Take us to break?
You want some caramel crack?
I can take you to break. Coming up.